Welcome to Business Innovators Radio, featuring industry influencers and trendsetters sharing proven strategies to help you build a better life right now.
Welcome to Brilliant Business TV, conversations with leading experts in business. I am your host, Mark Stephen Pooler. Today, we have a wonderful guest, Penelope Layzell. Penelope supports her clients to reduce their stress, anxiety, and mental health in the workplace. So stay tuned to meet Penelope. I am just making an official shout out to our show sponsors, Craig Shelley, Beverly Hills, Luxury Watches and Fine Jewelry at craigshelley.com. We are streaming live on mspnewsglobal.com. We're also on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, and we're also on the E360 TV network under Fresh Takes, going out to Roku, Apple TV, Fire TV, Android TV, and many, many more. So let's bring in our incredible guest, Penelope. Welcome, Penelope, to the Brilliance Business TV show.
Hi, Mark, and hi, everyone.
It's great to have you here, Penelope, and I know how passionate you are of supporting your clients to reduce stress, anxiety, improve their mental health in the workplace. Could we go back a little bit, Penelope, for your past, your background, and what has led you to do what you're doing today?
Certainly, Mark. So my background starts way back when I was a child, as most of my clients are similar. Where as a child, you learn to conform, to hide who you are, to sort of fit in with your parents' ideals. And when you go back out into the corporate world, you do exactly the same. And I started in the corporate world at 16. And therefore, I learned quite early on that I needed to be who they wanted me to be. But what that leads to is burnout. I'm in a very high pressured sales environment, long hours, you're constantly chasing for the next promotion. And I burnt out on so many occasions until finally I was incredibly ill, and that's when the brakes slammed on and I knew I needed to do something different, and that's what kick-started this business.
Great story. So from the age of 16 you went into the corporate world, Penelope. That's a very young age to go into corporate and then finding out that you have to fit into their ways. So in a way, change who you are as a person to fit their needs. And that has led you to burn out, but then inspired you to go on and create what you are doing today. So tell us a little bit about your business and how you support your clients now, Penelope.
So my business is supporting them to be able to gain the balance and just rebalance their life. So it starts from the spirituality side, and bringing in the spirituality to be able to just learn to manage your energy. And when you can learn to manage your energy, you can, you know, just stop that burnout in your tracks. I went from suffering crippling anxiety, to full burnout throughout my life, to completely healing myself. And that's what I teach my clients.
So tell us a little bit about the ha-ha moment, Penelope. So you have burnt out. Where did you go from there and what steps did you take to support you?
So from the burnout, and I didn't learn the first time, I burnt out two or three times, and then I had a major illness. I had breast cancer, which I fully know was the universe saying, slam the brakes on, you need to stop and pay attention now because you're going to make yourself really ill. So it was after the breast cancer and coming back, and you look to reevaluate things the way you were. And I've always been a little bit spiritual. So I started just weaving practices in myself to just manage what I was doing. But my aha moment came in the midst of the pandemic when I noticed my team were feeling incredibly burnt out themselves. We'd shrunk by 75% overnight. There was redundancies going around in the company. My team were under pressure to just perform, and you know, therefore their jobs were incredibly challenging. And so I told them to stop selling, and we were going to do it my way, which in a business that's failing was a little bit of a shock. But interestingly enough, their stress levels reduced, and we started to succeed, and we started to grow again, which was incredible. And I, you know, my team from there learned to weave these practices in themselves. But that was my aha moment, going, we could all do this. We can all go and step forward and make a change to the way we work and look after our bodies.
Great points there, Penelope. And I think it's the same for so many people out there. With all the negative that has happened through the lockdown, through the pandemic, I think it has really made a big shift in people's consciousness. I know myself, I thought this is going to be a long journey, and I have always been spiritual, Penelope, but I purposely started to focus a lot more on my spiritual growth. So I started meditating more and really doing the visualization and watching a lot of personal development and self-improvement. Because I realise there's a lot of negativity, but it's important to look after yourself and focus on the positives, even in the testing times. And I have had one of my best years in business because I chose to focus on all the good aspects, a good work ethic. Tell us a little bit about your spirituality, what it means to you, and what are your spiritual practices?
So spirituality to me, it's the lifeblood of what I do. And it's difficult to, you know, I always kept it separate. I've always been a little bit spiritual. I've always meditated. I've always, but not to the extent that I now do, because in the corporate, it doesn't quite sit and marry. And if I suddenly said, right, we're going to have a meditation session in the middle of the office, they might have laughed at me. But to me, it's so important. So I connect in with my higher self, and I have a non-physical team. So I have several guides that work with me, but my higher self is with me throughout the day. So I learned to listen to her, and I feel in my body areas of my body that need to, you know, if I get a bit of tension, I normally know it's her giving me, you need to step away from your desk. And little signs that the universe gives me, like the computer suddenly breaks and goes, that's it, it's not working. I don't get irritable like I used to. I go, okay, time for a cuppa. Let's go and have a cup of tea, do some breathing, and come back, and it'll all be sorted in a minute. It's the universe telling me to step away. So that's the spirituality that I bring to the office.
Now, there may be some people out there listening that may sound a little bit woo-hoo too. But Penelope, science and spirituality have never come so close together. And now science is backing up spirituality. So it's now proven that there is a field around all of us, and we are part of the field. And it's just such a great time to be alive, I feel, Penelope. I'm so spiritual, but it's proven that we're all connected, not only to each other, but every part of the universe is connected. I'm a big quantum physics fan as well, you may be able to see. So even though there may be people out there not realizing that there is an higher self, there is a field that affects the reality that we create, the way we react with the field, but don't you think it's just great that science now has proven a lot of these things that used to be classed as woo-hoo?
Oh, definitely, definitely. And, you know, when you're connecting with that energy, it's incredible to be able to almost plug yourself in and go, I can feel the universe is telling me this, and just to understand. And I call it free falling. So it's almost like allowing yourself to just move with the energy, because energy will drop, your vibration will lower, and you will feel it. And that's where the burnout comes, when you lower that vibration so low that you will get those illnesses, you will get that burnout. And I think it's incredible the science is now backing it, and I think it's time now to for the business world to embrace it too, and just to accept that, you know, enhancing that, you get far more out of your staff if you just enhance it and bring it into the workplace too.
I agree. It's like when you're in alignment or in the flow, you think better, you act better, and opportunities just seem to come to you. Everything flows. Whereas if you're in a lower vibration, you feel it. You just know by the way you feel. If you're in the flow, you feel good. If you're out of alignment, you don't feel good. And that's why I find little things like meditation, little bits of exercise, also diet does have an impact on the way you feel as well. These practices and visualization really helps me as well. It does really make you function better and improve the way that you're showing up in the world. Do you agree with me?
Completely, completely. It really does help just enhance everything that you're doing. And meditation is a big part. And when you learn to do meditation well, people see meditation as sitting in a corner, you know, chanting. You can actually do it sitting at your desk. You don't need to take yourself off for half an hour. I just push my chair back, take a few deep breaths. That's a meditation. You know, if you get a few moments throughout the day where you can just sit quietly, that's a meditation. It doesn't need to be push yourself away for half an hour. And so I think meditation is a huge one, just to recenter you and reset you back to the way you're going.
And it's all about just breathing, isn't it? It's all about the breath and clearing your mind. And I do about 5 to 10 minutes a day. And even that is scientifically proven to improve brain function. And for me, I feel better just doing 5 to 10 minutes meditation. It just has such an impact on the way I feel, Penelope. Penelope, I have really enjoyed talking to you for part one. Please stay where you are. We're just going to a commercial break. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for part one of Brilliance Business TV. We're joined with Penelope Layzell. She has shared her journey of starting in the corporate world at the age of 16. And realizing she has to fit into their way of doing things. And that led her to having to change who she was. It led to her having burnout, but it really drove her forwards into doing what she does today in helping reduce stress, anxiety, and mental health in the workplace. Join us after the commercial break. Welcome back to Brilliance Business TV. We're joined with Penelope Layzell. Before the commercial break, Penelope shared her journey of joining the corporate world at the age of 16 and realizing that she had to change who she was and fit into their ways. That led to her having burnout, but it led her on a journey to what she does today in reducing anxiety, stress, and mental health in the workplace. Welcome back to Brilliance Business TV, Penelope.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you.
So, Penelope, can you share some of the problems that workers are facing, employees are facing in the workplace?
So some of the problems that they face, obviously it depends on the industry, but a lot of the industries are very high pressure. They'll have KPIs, targets, very target driven. You feel like you need to drive yourself to burnout so that you can just step up the next level. You can sit for long hours of the day. I mean, you could sit there from, you know, 12 hours a day, sat at your desk sometimes. You can, you know, and that has stress and fatigue on your body. You tend to pigeonhole your work, your home life around your job. So your job is your main focus, and your physical life sits sort of around it, which again doesn't give you that balance. It doesn't give you that separation that you can balance, and if you can get it harmonized, that you can bring in some of the practices that I teach, you actually feel like you never work a day, and this is your personal life that you're working. And I encourage a lot of people to not leave the 9 to 5. I don't think there's a need to rush out the door because you're sat there for 12 hours a day and you've had enough and you're facing burnout. But if you can just change the way you work within that, I think it's incredible, because then you actually don't work a day in your life, and yet you're still sitting there for 12 hours. You're actually enjoying what you do because you pull out all the essence of the goodness and not the yucky stuff that comes with it.
More employers should really bring in this kind of approach, shouldn't they, Penelope? Because some bosses, they may feel, we're not doing that, that will never work, and they just want their teams to perform. But you have proved that when you do bring in these practices, it does improve sales, it does improve productivity. So more employers should bring in these skills and these practices, and it can only lead to more happy workers and better results within the workplace. Do you want to elaborate on that a little bit?
Definitely, because actually the sickness that comes from work-related stress is huge. So you actually lose more people and more downtime from people being stressed and underworked. I mean, 1 in 6 suffer with mental health in the workplace. So if you've got 1 in 6 employees and you're not physically working with them to, you know, get a place of work that actually is balanced and harmonious, you're going to end up with at least one member of your staff off regularly. And that costs you thousands and millions of pounds to cover the sickness, to cover it. Also impacts your other staff because they're covering that sickness. So if you can embrace this new way of working, you get a team that are really happy, really harmonious, really balanced, and production flows. They have less days off, they have less time away, they have less, you know, downtime because their vibration is low. And so overall, I mean, we're working in an environment that came in the Industrial Revolution, and we haven't changed, and we're in the 21st century, and it's ridiculous that we should be still going, well, what came in the Victorian times, we're still going to adhere to. And as you said earlier, Mark, the spirituality it's becoming well thought of within the science realm. So if we could embrace this moving forward and move into a fifth dimensional world, it would be amazing. It would be incredible.
I agree totally. And I think now would be a good time for us, because we have been through a global pandemic. a lot of people are now going back to their workplaces, and their bosses may be very stressed because they've got money to make because of how hard they have been hit. It's been a really tough time, and there will be people out there that are going to be very stressed, Penelope. They are going to have anxiety. Mental health could start to struggle because there may be pressure in the workplaces, going back to a lot of work to catch up with. Can you just share some tips for us, for anyone out there that's going back to the workplace or is in a stressful workplace, just to help them be able to move forward more positively?
Oh, definitely, definitely. So, I mean, if they're not in connection with their higher self and they've not really delved into the spiritual, it can be quite challenging to address it and go, okay, I'm now going to be a bit woo-woo. But try just writing. Journaling is a big part of what I teach. But you know, and a lot of people don't know how to journal. Just sit with a pen and just let words pop into your head. Just sit quietly, just a few minutes in the morning. That will allow you to start connecting inwards. Meditation, we've touched on, just a few minutes in the morning, just slowing your breathing down, cutting off distractions. You don't have to do anything major, just those little breathing techniques that are there, listening to your body as you go through the day. So when you're getting that tension in your shoulders, you know then that, you know, that's, it's time for you to move. I mean, how many of us don't take a lunch break or don't leave the desk? They're literally pigeonholed there. They might run to the toilet and grab a coffee, but that's pretty much where they sit, you know. So that tension is your body. Just have a walk around the office, just step out into the air and breathe the outside air. That's all you need. You don't need your hours long break, you know. Yes, ideally it would be lovely, but in corporate world it doesn't happen, so I'm not going to, you know, force everybody to take an hour's break because they'd probably have a breakdown themselves. But, you know, just stepping out of the office, breathing in the air, coming back in is a meditation. So even doing that will help.
Journaling is a big one as well. And I used to journal very heavily, actually. And sometimes when you look back of all the things that you have journaled about, some of them are what you want, some is about what's happened through the day. It's quite fascinating when you go back on old journals and you think, oh, my life, I have achieved that. That's come true now. And it's a great way of programming the subconscious mind as well, because the mind learns from writing. It's getting the creative part of your mind flowing, and that really helps to go straight into the subconscious mind. Meditating is really, really important. Breathing, and like you mentioned, you don't have to spend an hour in a corner umming to meditate. It is just about clearing the mind and just breathing and really being aware of the breath and breathing a little bit slower, like you mentioned. So I loved all your tips. Now, you have mentioned a little bit about spirituality. You're in corporate, which maybe a few years ago they didn't really go hand in hand, and we still have got a long way to go. Can you share how corporate and spirituality link together?
Oh, definitely. So they link together because if you can embrace the spiritual side and you can, you know, put all your preconceptions to one side and actually allow the spirituality to come in, as you said, it raises your vibration and therefore things naturally attract to you. And like I alluded to earlier when I was talking about, you know, in the midst of the pandemic, when we started to succeed, when I told my team to stop selling in the middle of a pandemic, when we were a sales team, you know, it was, but because they aligned, they readdressed and pushed their vibration up, we started selling without selling. And we started seeing the success come in. So I think there is a real need for the spirituality and the corporate to start to just link in together.
And another word that you have talked about a lot today, which is so important, healing. Now, I am a big fan of some of the greats like Greg Braden, Dr. Bruce Lipton, and they talk a lot about how we can heal our bodies. You have touched on healing a lot. Can you share how healing is important and elaborate more about healing and the importance of it?
So healing is so incredible. As I said earlier, I cured myself of anxiety and, you know, and mental health through the healing. But it goes deeper than that. So the illness that I had was breast cancer. I'm on tamoxifen, which makes me very fatigued, very tired. Again, the healing that I did, right, you know, I don't suffer with that anymore. So if you can heal inside, you're then naturally going to feel better in your body and you're going to feel better moving forward. But the healing goes deeper. The type of healing I do can remove blocks that in your subconscious that you don't know that was there. I link into a megadome, which is energy. So I can look at the energy. I work very strongly with your life force. So I'm looking at your life force patterns throughout your body and I can see where blockages are and I can just shift those out so that you feel freer in yourself. And that enables you to work in a freer way as well. So I tend to lead my clients through the healing into the career coaching side of things, because it's only when the healing comes about can you then start focusing on your career aspirations. Because if you're trying to do your career aspirations without the healing, you're going to hit that ceiling constantly and you're going to constantly feel that burnout. So I take them through the healing first.
That makes total sense, Penelope. We all hold on to a lot of trauma, a lot of baggage. So it makes sense to heal and then to focus on business, because if you do it the other way around, it seems a little bit backwards. So that really does make sense to me. Now, we was part of a collaboration project together, The Law of Brand Attraction 2, with the incredible Dr. John DeMartini as the foreword. The brains behind it was Sammy Blindel. And I think there were about another 27 co-authors in the book as well. Just tell us a little bit about your chapter in that.
So my chapter talks about my journey and it goes into quite a deep area of my journey. I know I touched on it a little bit earlier, but it goes a lot deeper, my childhood trauma and, you know, and how that affected me in the corporate world. So my chapter talks about that. It also talks about some of the tips that we've discussed. One of the big tips that I use for my clients to see if they're in the right profession and they're in the right job that they actually love, that's in the chapter. So you'll be able to see that and be able to use that to see whether you are where you are supposed to be, because that's another big element is, are we doing what we should be doing? Is this what our universal calling is? And I can help. I normally help my clients to align to their purpose. So that, again, is all in the chapter that I wrote.
I would encourage everyone. I have a chapter in this incredible book as well. It's available on Amazon and you can go to thelawofbrandattraction.com. There will be so much wisdom and knowledge in this book to help you with your business and your personal lives. And Penelope's amazing chapter is in the book as well. So go to The Law of Brand Attraction 2. Now, you have an event coming up, Penelope, and it's a group meditation healing. Tell us a little bit about this.
So a lot of my clients, when they're first coming through, don't see how the healing can work, and particularly the energy healing that I do. So this event coming up on the 30th of June, it's in the evening. So it works really, really well with my corporate clients. It's in the evening. It's only £17 and it will just be an hour to raise your vibration, to reduce the stress and fatigue of the day, and just to energize your soul. And it's a really nice taster for anybody that's a little bit sitting on the fence about whether the healing works, because of the way that I connect into the megadome and leverage the energy from there. I can then leverage that into your soul. So that's what I'll be doing on the 30th. So I've got a spare hour and you want to come along and just experience that healing for yourself. It is incredible, the healing that I am able to do as a certified healer. And the testimonials I've got from clients, you know, are exceptional. So if you just want a taster, just dip your toe in a little bit, then join me on the 30th, because it will be an amazing hour.
I would encourage everyone, if you really feel a group meditation healing would be of benefit to you, or if you're struggling with stress, anxiety, depression, mental health for the workplace issues, contact Penelope via email, penelope@dimension.co.uk. That's penelope@dimension.co.uk. Penelope, I have really enjoyed having a conversation with you today. Thank you so much for coming on to the Brilliance Business TV show.
Thank you, Mark. And thank you so much for having me, because I'm so passionate about this. I just want to get it out into the world and change the way we work forever. So thank you very much.
You're making an impact and doing great service, Penelope, and it's been our pleasure. Thank you once again. Thank you for joining us for Brilliance Business TV. Today, we have had the wonderful Penelope Layzell as a guest. She has shared how she started her corporate career at the age of 16. She had to fit into the corporate world and their way of doing things, which led her to change herself, and that led to her having burnout. But the one great thing this pandemic did was give Penelope a ha-ha moment, and now Penelope supports people in the workplace to reduce stress, anxiety, depression and mental health. Thank you everyone for watching Brilliance Business TV. Until next time, bye.
Thanks for listening to Business Innovators Radio. To hear all episodes featuring leading industry influencers and trendsetters, visit us online at businessinnovatorsradio.com today.